Hey, what's going on, everyone? Big Bob with Tales of a King. Welcome back to King of the Week. Today we're in San Bernardino, California. We're going to check out Raul's 2013 Road King Classic. Stay tuned. Hey, what's going on, everyone? Big Bob of the Road King Nation and Tales of a King. Today we're with Raul. How you doing, Raul?
Hi, Bob.
And we're gonna check out his 2013 Road King Classic, man. And a lot of the work was done by Raul, and we'll get into that. So Raul, when you bought the bike, 2013,
yes.
Was it stock or?
It had upgrades. It had like just chrome stuff here and there, you know, but it wasn't like a complete upgrade. It was a stock bike.
Yeah.
Yes.
So it had like a lot of the aftermarket chrome that
it had a lot of aftermarket chrome, aftermarket beach bar, stuff like that, but nothing extra.
And I remember when you got it, you went to, we were doing a show in LA, or taco shop, huh?
Yeah, it was at
you cruised up, we had the beach bar, I remember the beach
that's
bar.
Actually the first ride I actually rode out anywhere further, because I never owned a bike.
Yeah.
That was the first bike I ever bought, so when I rode it, I mean, I was jamming on the freeway, fucking, to see what happened.
So before, you were into cars and stuff, right?
Yes, yes. I've always been into cars, little. I mean, my dad's always been a mechanic, so
yeah.
I've caught on to it.
Now your car's a La Tortuga.
La Tortuga.
Get it right. Yeah, that's not a lowrider. Is it considered a lowrider or considered?
I would say it's considered a custom low.
Oh, custom, okay.
Custom, I mean, because it's got French taillights, got all that stuff. So
yeah.
I mean,
and we'll get some footage of that. It's not complete, but it still looks.
Yeah,
good.
It still looks all right.
Has been driven.
It comes anyway, nice.
So this is your first bike, the 2000.
This is actually my first bike. Yes.
How you like it?
I love Harley, man. It's just something different. Like I've been into cars forever, and there's just nothing like it. You know, you're one-on-one with the road and just rolling.
Hell yeah.
Just cruising.
Now, most of the work, you did a lot of work to it lately. What did you do?
I did all the paint work. I did all the paint work. I did some of the metal fabrication parts of it, as far as like stretching out the fenders.
Mm. You did it yourself?
Yeah. Making the saddlebag guards, stuff like that. But paint work, it was cool. I had Black Rooster from LA do my pin, the pinstriping and the gold leafing.
Yeah, so nice.
That's pretty cool.
Black Rooster Customs. Yeah, and all, you know, Rooster, all those names, you guys, will be at the bottom in the description, as well as, you know, a little pop-up thingy.
And then I just had Dago Dane do all the engraving, of course.
Yeah. So the guard bag guards. Yes. You made those?
Yes, I made those. Yeah, I seen those on a bike, and I figured I try it. If I can pull it off, then fuck yeah. If not, then I'll just buy some. Fuck it.
You guys need bag guards, get it roll, man. He'll take care of you.
I'll hook you up.
But now the paint, you painted the bike, but didn't do the gold leaf.
Yes, yes. I painted the bike. I took it to him completely painted, but sanded down so that he can do all the gold leafing. And then when I got it all back from him, I just shot clear over everything.
But you painted it.
Yes, I painted it completely. Impressive. I did all the everything, all the pattern work, all the everything, lace, everything, yes.
And you paint at work as well, right?
No, at work I do collision. I'm actually a collision repair tech. I do car comes in fucking smashed. I fix it, make it look like it never got hit ever again.
Man, you got all in one here, you guys.
Yeah, I could never work in an office. I coming out of high school, my mom told me, hey, you're either gonna go to school or you're gonna just go to work. I said, I'll go to work.
Yeah, fuck that. I'm not going back to school.
Yeah, I can't work in an office. I'm not. Look at these fucking hands. They're mittens, you know?
Hell yeah.
I can't work in an office.
Yeah, man. So I want to talk about the bag guards again.
Yeah.
Did you have them fabricated or did you do them in-house? Or?
No, I bought all the metal.
Metal.
I bought the tube bender on Amazon for like 130 some bucks.
Yeah.
I did it all here. I mean, it's just metal, I guess you could say.
So what, do you just find like a radius and I mean,
I just started bending metal.
That's pretty impressive.
I just started bending metal. I just
really?
Like, seeing the way I liked it and just try to match the other one to the other one.
I mean,
can't see both at the same time, so it's like whatever.
Yeah, because it looks good. If you need custom bag guard to hit up a roll.
Yeah, hit me up. Hook you up.
Yeah, he gives me paints and everything. Big boss. You don't want that. But no, they look good, man, and that's impressive. So.
Thank you.
Now the engraving was done by Dago Dane, right?
Yes, sir.
And because the way it sets off, and you guys will see, would you call it like an accents of it? Because it's not like just loaded with engraving.
Yeah,
like,
I didn't want to overtake the bike with engraving. I wanted to just give it more of a classy look with the engraving.
And that's exactly, to me, that's exactly what it looks like.
Yeah,
looks
I didn't want to do too much of it. And I mean, as far as it goes, I'm not going to add that much more to it, but I will add more engraving.
More engraving?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
Just in little areas here and there.
Right, right.
More of a, just to give this area some engraving, give this area, not to fill the bike up with engraving.
No, because I think exactly, to me, you know, how you have it just gives it that little extra
I mean, there's
pop.
There's some beautiful bikes out there with a lot of engraving, a lot of it, but it's just, to me, I think it's too much. I don't like it. The bikes look really beautiful, but it's just not my style, I guess.
That's like the paint.
Yeah.
Because I'm going to have Raul paint my bike, I think. And, well, he probably is. And I love, like, the bikes. I think I've said this before, but I can't keep it clean. I don't fucking... Yeah. Just keep it black, and we're good to go.
Yeah.
But, and that's how I feel about the engraving. Like, I love the engraving, but I feel like the way you have it, for me, it's, like, perfect. Like, it's not loud, and it's just, like, it gives it that... Sets it off just that little bit extra.
Yeah, I've never really... didn't want to take care of my bike, like, as far as every day, and ever since I started doing the paintwork, and I did the paintwork, and I painted it, and it's all complete. I mean, my bike's covered in the garage now and everything. It's a pain in the ass to keep it clean, man.
Yeah.
So yeah,
the way you have it really pops it off to me. I think it's perfect.
Thank you.
What's the deal with the foxtail?
Honestly, I don't know what the fuck the deal is. I just,
because it looks like badass. Like, there's no meaning.
That's the only reason I put it on there. I mean, we went to a little car show, and my son bought it, $12, and he put it on my bike, and I thought it looked cool as fuck, so I gave him $20 for it. I was like, here, I'll buy it off you.
He made $8.
So he made $8 off it. He went and bought himself a $15 one this time. You know?
Hell yeah. No, it was good.
And still had $5 in his pocket, so it was cool.
Maybe you could fabricate some of those, too.
Yeah.
I'll buy one.
You gotta go buy a bunch of fox, or find foxes, something, I don't know.
Now, you said Black Rooster did all the
He did all the leafing, and he did the actual lettering on the tank.
And is he a painter, or what is...
He does custom paint work. Oh, he does really nice work. I like his work, too.
Now, gold leaf, and I remember we had Sid on here. That's a technique, right? It's art.
Yeah, so that's some stuff.
You don't do that?
I've never. I just didn't want to try it out on my bike because it was already there, and I didn't have to start all over. But eventually, I want to get into it and start doing that stuff.
Nice. Yeah. You could do all in one shop.
Yeah, I want to just do
it. Bad guards, paint, foxtails.
Yeah, I mean, gold leafing. I would still probably just... do that as a side gig and just keep my regular job. Just
and you guys, this is where it all, well, I don't know if you can see the background, but this is where it all happened right here.
Yeah,
right?
This garage here, yeah. This is where everything happens, actually, yeah.
So all the magic happens right here.
Yeah, this is where we hang out, drink, kick it, everything.
Hell yeah. I'm not drinking today.
No.
It's too early in the morning.
I pretend it's Vegas.
Yeah, so, I mean, your bike is beautiful.
Thank you.
Did you envision it, how it came out, or before
it actually did. It actually is... I mean, yeah, I'm still envisioning more stuff to it, but as far as right now, yeah, I envision. Yeah.
And what was like the push to end up just doing it, or did you just be like, fuck it, or was it?
You know what? When that whole pandemic stuff started, I said if we're gonna be shut down, I might as well stay home and do something. So I went and bought materials, paint, fucking candy colors, and said, fuck it, let's take this bitch apart and let's get it going.
So something, came out.
Yeah, I figured
positive
I figured if we're gonna be shut down and have to be stayed home, then fuck it, let's.
You got plenty of time to make it happen.
Yeah.
And it worked out good.
Yeah.
Man, that thing is nice. And you got air right in the front and back.
Front and back, yes. I got a whole kit from American Suspension.
Okay.
They're in based out in Anaheim.
Oh, okay.
And I did the front, I did the rear.
So who put that air on?
I did all that too.
Oh shit, you did that too.
Yeah, I did all the mechanical work, did all that stuff, like, I mean, it's basically
hands-on. Front and rear, you guys. Front, was it considered front, right? Front end?
Yeah, front.
I don't want to get it wrong. Right. Someone's going to email me, you idiots.
Yeah, it's not the front.
It's not the front. But you got front, back, and then your knobs, which you guys will see, obviously. Are those custom or?
That's actually, it comes with the whole kit.
Oh, really?
They have a whole setup. It's just really cool the way they set it up. It's just really, really easy to put in.
Too. Yeah, yeah.
It's not that bad. So,
the front was easy? I don't fuck with none of that stuff. That's why intrigued.
I don't do books, so I'm more mechanically inclined.
Okay.
You know what I mean? So I was able to actually do it.
Nice.
I figured, what's the worst that could happen? I just take it apart again and have somebody else do it.
No, it looks good, and then we'll, of course, we'll get some shots. Now, you got that La Corona gas cap by Road King Nation.
Mr. Road King Nation.
Right here. That thing looks sick. I think that without that, the bike would be nothing.
I believe the same.
No, it looks good, man. But overall, dude, we love your bike, man, and we appreciate you letting us come out here and
thank you.
Having us. And
my honor.
Appreciate it, bro.
Yep.
Thank you. Thank you guys for tuning in to another edition of Tales of a King, featuring Raul, King of the Week. You guys stay tuned. King Life.